Howdy, this is Chris Bertelson with a quick clip from Nevada Learning Series. Let's get connected with connectivity on the iPad 2. A lot of the utility that comes from using the iPad is the fact it's connected to the internet. You manage your connections through settings, and in settings I'm going to tap on general over here on the left, and third down from the top is network. By tapping on that, I have a couple of different networks I can use. Most people use the Wi-Fi connection or the wireless connection. So let's tap on that. And I'm going to turn that Wi-Fi network connection on. And you can see under Choose a Network, it lists different Wi-Fi networks that it finds available. The little radiating radio waves on the right indicate the signal strength. I have three that are very strong here. If they were weak, you'd only see one or maybe two bars over there. And the check mark next to Bertelsen A indicates that it has automatically connected to that. The nice thing is once you connect up to a network, it will then remember that network, and the next time you are in range, it will automatically connect for you. If it prompts you for a password, you enter the password, and then it remembers the password the next time you're there. Sometimes the networks are hidden. They're not broadcasting their name, and you need to tap on Other. Go in and type the specific name of the network ID, the password, and then you're good to go. You're connected, and it will remember that the next time. You can also turn off Ask to Join Networks if you don't want it to automatically connect, though I find that to be a fairly convenient feature. Sometimes you need to do a little troubleshooting on your connection, and to do that, you touch the blue arrow on the right. And when you do, you drill down and you can see the IP numbers or the internet numbers that are assigned to your computer to connect up. And in many cases, you don't need to worry about these, but occasionally you might need to read those to someone if you're on a support call. Under Renew Lease, if I tap on that, it will try to reconnect to the network by refreshing those numbers. Oftentimes, if I don't have a good connection, that's all I need to do to make it work. These other settings probably should not be changed unless you have the guidance of some IT people. If I back out of network, another way that I can connect is using a virtual private network or a VPN. This is a very secure, encrypted connection. Typically, you might use this if you had a business connection to the internet or to your network. If you use this, it prompts you for the proper information. You get this from your IT people, you type that in, it remembers it, and then you're good to go with a very secure connection through that VPN. If you're using a wireless carrier, such as AT&T or Verizon, you'll see their network listed here, and you can manage that connectivity there as well. Another way that you can connect up to your iPad is through Bluetooth. Bluetooth quite often works with wireless headphones or maybe a wireless keyboard. I'm going to turn on Bluetooth here. It does a search for any Bluetooth devices and it finds my iPhone, so I could connect up to that if I wanted to. Many times I'm flying and they ask that you turn off all of the wireless connectivity to your iPad. To do that, you go to the upper left-hand corner here where it says airplane mode, and I'm going to switch that on. When I'm in airplane mode, you'll notice that Bluetooth has been turned off. It says off behind that. And in the upper left-hand corner of my screen, I see a little airplane symbol indicating that I am in airplane mode. When I land, I try and connect, and nothing is working. I go out to the browser, and it says you need to turn off airplane mode or use Wi-Fi to access data. All right, so we're going to go into settings. And I'm going to turn off airplane mode. And when I do, you'll notice that the iPad appears in the upper left-hand corner with a little radio signal strength there for my Wi-Fi connection. By the way, another shortcut that you can use to go into Wi-Fi is just to tap on Wi-Fi underneath airplane mode, and that takes you into the same place. The best way to test our connection is to go to the browser, tap on a link. Let's say we want to plan our visit to the Grand Canyon. It searches, it finds, and we are connected and on the internet. So that's a little bit of the basics of how you can get connectivity on your iPad. This has been a quick clip from Nevada Learning Series, helping you get the most from your Apple iPad.